Hi, Steve from GuitarZoom here, and I want to talk about another really awesome app that you can use if you're learning how to play some open chords, maybe some power chords, things like that, and you're looking for some songs that are pretty straightforward and easy to play. This app is called Four Chords, and again, I'm assuming it's available for Android, but I don't know because I don't own an Android phone. But let me show you what this looks like. So I'm going to click on it, and it opens. And here I am. What I'm going to do is I'm going to choose select a song. And then when I get to this page here, I have what's called My Songbook, which are the songs that I've already downloaded that I've used for, you know, other students and things like that. But what I want to do is see there's free songs and there's extremely easy to play and top downloads, all these kind of things. What I can do, see where it says top downloads? If I click on that, it compresses them all. And now I can see the different categories that this app has to offer. So extremely easy to play, free song of the week, you know, what's new, whatever it might be. There's all kinds of different things in here. Born to Rock. So I'm going to choose Born to Rock. We'll see what's in there. Okay, so there's quite a number of Beatles songs here. There's a Chubby Checker song, Tom Petty. And they're adding new songs all the time. But here's all kinds of different things. So I'm going to go up to the top there, and I'm going to choose Can't Buy Me Love. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the title, Can't Buy Me Love. And what you see there is a list of the chords that will be used in this particular song. Now, some of those chords are probably minor as well, but this little preview doesn't show you which ones are major and which ones are minor. You won't know until you actually click on the little blinking arrow on the right-hand side there. But let's say we're going to do that one. So I like Can't Buy Me Love, and I feel pretty confident with these chords. So I click on that little arrow, and it downloads the song, and then it prepares it. So here we go. So here's the chords I need for this song. Okay, I need E minor, A minor, C, F, and G. So there's all my chord charts for the songs. So if I don't know how to play an F chord, I can look at that chord chart, and I can learn how to play it. If I need more help with learning these chords, this is really awesome. On the bottom, you can see there's a tab called Learn Chords. If I click on that tab, it pulls up little videos for each chord to teach me how to play each chord if I need the help. And then next to it, you'll see there's power chords. Well, this shows you how to play all five of those chords in power chord form. In case maybe you're working on power chords or you just prefer power chords, it's fine. And then there's another tab on the bottom which says strumming. Now, this just simply gives you an idea of a strumming pattern that you could use for this song, which is pretty cool. Again, there's a little watch link there you can see. If you click on that, the justinguitar.com, which is who created this app, there's going to be a video on there that shows you how to do this strumming pattern. So it's just a really awesome app for learning how to play some popular, fun songs. And yet fairly straightforward, and even teaching you how to do some strums to it, you know, how to play the chords to each thing, that sort of thing. And once you've got it all together, you know, you can click on the tuner up on top and it shows you the six strings with the notes. If you click on each one of those notes, it's going to play through your phone and you can tune your guitar to it. And then when you're ready to go, over on the right-hand side, it says Let's Go. And when you click that, it's going to pop up, and all of a sudden these little chord charts are going to pop up in front of you and tell you when to play each one. Unfortunately, I can't click on that right now because if I do, the app that I'm using to record my iPhone will crash. And I've done that about 17 times now, so I need to stop doing that. So you got to take my word for it that it really is an amazing app and a wonderful way of being able to play some songs using some regular chords like this. So if you get a chance, please make sure that you check this out. We'll go back here. Four Chords, just a really truly amazing app.